So today I want to talk about a very interesting topic, the lead in nutritional supplements. Now, there's a California regulation called Prop 65. It's known as the Safe Drinking Water Intoxic Enforcement Act of 1986. So it was probably a really good idea when they started it 25 years ago. But now it's kind of gotten out of hand because now it involves over 900 different chemicals. And so this bypasses the FDA, and they have their own guidelines or thresholds that you can't go over in certain chemicals and heavy metals, et cetera. And so certain companies are forced to put warning labels on their products. So the labels say something like, ingestion of this product is known to Californians to cause potential cancers or reproductive harm. Now, what's really fascinating to me about this Prop 65 is that, let's just take lead, for example. The FDA allows 12 micrograms of lead to be consumed per day if you're an adult. If you're a child, it's 3 micrograms. But if you're in California, because of this Prop 65, the threshold is 0.5 as far as creating some reproductive toxicity. So the FDA allows 12 micrograms per day, and Prop 65 allows 0.5 micrograms per day as far as their limit. Now, it's almost impossible to differentiate the naturally occurring lead that comes from the soil versus lead that comes from pollution. So anything grown in the soil is bound to have a certain amount of lead in it. Just because we live on the earth and the earth is made up of elements, and lead is one of the elements. Now, there's a couple of very interesting things on how these numbers were set. Number one, they used animal studies, okay? I mean, animals are similar to humans, but they're not identical. So that's one variable right there that it's very difficult to equate what's happening to an animal to humans. All right, number two, they measured the quantity of exposure of a given element like lead that will result in an observational effect. Now, first of all, what is an observational effect? This is what they use as statistically significant increase in risk of either cancer or reproductive harm. But this next point is quite mind-blowing to me. Check this out. They then take this number, whatever it is, certain amount of lead that creates this observational effect, and they set the threshold at 1/1000th of that number. So for example, if they found some effect that was created at 49 milligrams of lead, they would set the threshold at 49 micrograms, 1,000 times less. So to me, these numbers don't necessarily mean they're unsafe at all. In fact, what is said on the warning labels is what's called misleading speech. And this is a legal term that means speech that is actually or inherently deceptive, such that an ordinary consumer would be misled by the statement. Why? Because it reports a false fact. Now, what's false about this? We're using numbers that are 1,000 times less than the actual number that they found some observational effect. So if someone sells a product that is food-based or a whole food type product, they're bound to be over this limit. In fact, if you actually just look up the lead in certain vegetables, actually it's quite interesting. Potatoes have over 30 milligrams of lead per kilogram. Radishes have just under 50 milligrams per kilogram, and spinach leaves have just under 60 milligrams per kilogram of lead. Cauliflower is just under 70 milligrams per kilogram of lead. So it's fascinating how much lead is in our food supply already that may be naturally occurring. We don't know. It's impossible to differentiate the pollution from naturally occurring in the soil. So anyway, I just wanted to bring up this very interesting topic on lead and let you know how these numbers were really created, because apparently it doesn't necessarily mean it's unsafe simply because the threshold is set up to be 1,000 times less than what they found. So if you're enjoying my content, which I hope you are, and you're applying this knowledge to your health and you have a success, I'd really appreciate you sharing your success story. So click the link down below to my website, where you can upload your success story so you can help inspire others.